All right, welcome back to SRD Plays Yaz Road to the show. We continue this series with the Atlanta Braves. Yaz, had a couple hits the last game. The Diamondbacks have lost a couple games, though, and we need to turn this stuff and keep winning. We're like five games up over the San Francisco Giants currently for first place in the NL West. We have Shelby Miller on the mound, who's having a good year. He's 8-2 with a 3.89 ERA, so let's go. Here's our man, Yaz. We got a runner on first and second already. Yaz is looking to drive the ball somewhere. He wants to put one in the gap, if nothing else. Play here this afternoon. It was another loss last time out, and this portion of the schedule has not done him any favors as they've dropped five of their last seven. Matt, this has been one of those up and down teams. They lost the last game. Today, they don't want to give him the fastball.
Everybody wants to play above 500 baseball. Maybe they'll be motivated by that alone. He's set. Here
comes the 1-1. Good pitch. Tough slider down low. Good pitch. 1-2 count. Well, he's in a bit of hot water. If I was them, I'd be trying to bust him inside, but you know, I'm not them. He has a lot better chance of settling. See if he tries to do it though. Nope. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Curveball up and I swing at it. Might have been a strike, I don't know. It's automatic out. Okay, we're 0-1. Next at bat, runners at first and second. Here in the early going.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball. Ball one.
Well, he's been laboring a bit through these first two innings of work. That's 37 pitches. And ideally, he'd be closer to 27 instead.
I don't know where that pitch was going, but it wasn't going into the strike zone, that's for sure. Runners at first and second. 2-0 count, fastball count. Oh, don't think I got it all. Nope. Rats. Oh well. Let's regroup. We do have a 19-game hitting streak on the line, so I would like to, if nothing else, continue that streak. Get it 20 games. It would be a nice little achievement. Here comes the 0-1. Slider. Oh, come on, Blue.
Oh, that was a good looking slider to hit. He kind of hung him one. When you got a slider right there,
I think it's too high, man.
Towards you, that's the one you annihilate.
Too high. 1-2.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower,
staying alive.
Can and will
staying alive. Staying big. Alive.
Here's another 1-2.
Outside, good eye.
A pitch outside as they draw even 2-2.
Boy, that's a tough pitch to lay off right there, just out of the strike zone. But listen, when you're a 300 hitter, you don't chase a lot of those so-called pitcher's pitches. This guy knows.
Get there, safe. Oh, I thought I had it. Thought I had my 20-game hitting streak. Give it to him, Yaz. Give him a mouthful, man.
Number 8, fourth trip to the plate for him, and he's at risk of ending that nice hitting streak that he's put together.
Yeah.
Chances are it's on his mind, Matt, but you just have to let that get out of the way as best you can. You have to approach this at bat.
There's the hitting streak is alive with 20 games. Yes. Wait until the last minute to do it.
The graphic right there that his hitting streak will indeed live on as he just continues to hit the ball well.
I love the hitting streak. I was glad to see him get that knock. I was hoping we weren't going to jinx him.
All right.
And so now the Braves will get both
tied up 3-2. There we go.
Struck him out. And the inning is over.
All right, all that for nothing. All right.
Ready for another chance.
We're still tied up. We got a left-hander up in there.
Before the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. And a dive, but he's back in there.
They want to go outside.
Here's the first pitch. Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two?
No.
Back
Okay. All right. He thought he was out of it, but sorry. Hate to disappoint. All right, Jake. Way high throw. All right. Come on, Jake.
Yeah, you can't blame the pitcher on that one. He did all he could do. That was just an impressive show of speed.
What's gonna give?
Now the 3-2 pitch. Liner towards
second. Oh. He hits it hard, but right at the second baseman. Come on, David Peralta. You're 2-for-4.
He went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4. Here's the 2-2 pitch.
Okay, he goes down swinging.
Ready once again.
All right, we're out in the field. It's still tied up.
Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Out in front as this is skied in the air to straightaway left. Number 8 is there, and he'll bring this one.
All right.
Digging in and looking for more.
Two outs in the bottom of the 10th.
A singles for him in 4 trips for him this afternoon. Tries to go the other way as this is in the air.
Why am I going back? I didn't push my stick back.
Fielder, and that ends the inning.
All right. Come on, team. Let's go. Oh, my gosh. They took the lead and... Oh my God! I had delusions of grandeur there, man. I thought that pitch was gonna be gone. That was right in the wheelhouse, man. I just missed it. Just missed it, and we lost. Oh, he pops it up. He pops it up.
All right.
All right. Let's go back to the clubhouse and play another game. Okay, we're back home, and we're taking on the Arizona Cardinals for the second game of this episode. Zach Greinke on the mound, who's 4-4. His ERA is all right, under 3. That means the team's not hitting for him when he pitches. So, yeah, let's go see what happens here. Let's see if we can turn that around for him. We're out in the field, though.
Starts. I don't know if he has the stamina or not. We'll see if he can go as deep in this one as well.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Under it is the
all
left
right,
fielder. And
there
that's
we go.
The first out of the inning.
First at bat, we got a 20-game hit streak going. So let's see if we can continue it. There we go. That's going to continue it. Towering shot. The thing was way up there, man.
So it's a 3-run shot to straightaway right field. Home run number 16 for him on the year. As the D-backs have now taken a 3-0.
That's what you call a moonshot. 400 feet. It was very high.
I know I get big money for my expert analysis, but this is pretty simple. If you put a fastball up in the zone,
way up there,
this guy's gonna turn it around in a heartbeat. This one was no shot.
Okay, that might have been in the rafters if the roof was on.
Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. He was hitless in yesterday's show.
All right, we got a 3-0 lead right off the bat. That's a beautiful thing. Pitchers love that. Greinke loves it. But he don't love it enough to try to keep it because he just gave up a home run to Piscotty. Crush, 445 feet. That's way up there, man. Can you make it? Not quite up to that deck. All right, come on, Greinke.
Splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Pitch is popped up. Lamb posts under it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
All right, Jake Lamb. All right, let's see if we can repeat that.
Once again, number 8, as we move on to the bottom of inning number 3.
Oh, he almost gave me the same pitch. Oh, my gosh. Just throw me the fastball, dude. I love it.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Liner towards second.
Yeah.
Retired one away.
Okay. Yeah, you hit it hard. It's all right. All right, Piscotty. We're up 5-4 now. Cranky's let up 4 runs already.
Fly ball out toward left center field.
Can't get it.
He can't get there, so the inning will continue. And he's safe.
Wow, he got into second.
Almost got him out of the inning,
but damn it, Piscotty. You're irritating. All right, they tied it up.
He launched one over the wall back in the opening frame.
Too high, right?
And here's a ball hit in the air.
Yeah, it was too high. Should have left it alone. Should have left it alone. I'm 1-for-3 now. They got the new pitcher in, the left-hander.
Into the windup and the pitch. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul strike one.
Slider ball guy.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1.
Inside. Hey.
That'll keep him honest at the plate.
He went deep earlier, so that might have been a little bit of a message they were trying to send to get him off the plate. At the very least, they're clearly trying to get him from getting his arms extended again.
This is hit high in the air. Not
deep enough.
Has to range back, but he'll make the catch near the line.
I was hoping he was going to curl around that pole, but it didn't happen. Okay, the top of the ninth.
Leading off for St. Louis. Second baseman.
This is hit high in the air out to left field. And the
easy out.
Is retired here, one away.
Okay, come on.
Digging in once again, Eric Hosmer.
Eric Hosmer up.
After striking out his last time up. Here it comes on 1-1. That's lifted the other way out to left. Left fielder has a beat on it. One away.
Okay, reaction. I kind of ran in that direction right away.
Ready for another shot now.
All right.
Number 8. He's 1-for-4 for the game.
Number 8.
Oh, Lord.
And he's right on the fastball there.
Get on there. Get out. Get out. No, to the track. And we lose. We lose again. What is going on here, man? Yeah, it was 1-for-5. He had the home run. He's got the 21-game hitting streak. Not good when you lose both games in an episode. All right, well, that's going to be it for this episode. If you like the episode, leave a like. If you've not yet subscribed, please do. I appreciate it. And we'll catch you next time on SID Plays Yaz. Road to the show. Thanks.